So let's define an important idea called drug exposure. And we'll have to do this, we'll have to talk about a concept called area under curve, which we can actually calculate from a CP time curve. In healthcare, a drug's exposure is quantified in terms of plasma concentration and time. And so it's natural that we will use a CP time curve to determine a drug's exposure through something called area under curve. So exposure is equal to the measured area under curve for our CP time plot. It is possible to use curve fitting and calculus to determine AUC. In practice, however, AUC for a CP time curve is estimated through something called the trapezoid approximation method. In the trapezoid method, the curve is divided into regions split between the data points. AUC is calculated by adding the areas between data points as trapezoids. Pick two adjacent data points, average the two CP values, and then multiply the average by the time difference between the points. The first area is actually a triangle, but the equation still works. The final region is a little more difficult and does not work with the equation. Instead, we can use the drug's half-life, which is the time required for CP to drop by 50%. If the drug's half-life is known, then AUC for the last region is equal to the last plasma concentration data point times the half-life divided by 0.693. The sum of these different areas is the total AUC, the total exposure for the dose. The units for AUC are mass times time divided by volume. So if CP has units of micrograms per liter and time is in hours, then AUC is microgram hours per liter. Always mind your units when reading this type of data. Drugs do not have an ideal AUC value for a dose. Every drug is different, but monitoring AUC allows correlation of how exposure can vary across different patients or different routes of administration. We've now defined exposure in terms of the area under curve for a dose, and we've seen how to calculate area under curve for a CP time curve.